Hello everyone, welcome back. So today our topic is 21 CFR part 211 sub part D, equipment. So we would like to know about how to maintain the equipment, how to design. So size, locations and construction like that. So sub part D having a few sub guidelines like 211.6.3. So, says about equipment design, size and location. So, how to design equipment which is we are going to intend to produce a pharmaceutical product, and what are the size and location where we have to place in the equipment. And 211.6.5, equipment construction. So suitability of the equipment. So, what is the make and how to do construction of the equipment. And 211.6.7, equipment cleaning and maintenance. So design and size, location and construction is okay. So we have to think about how to clean the equipment, what are the requirements and what are the maintenance for the equipment like. So and the next is 211.6.8, automatic, mechanical and electronic equipment. So how equipment should be like, I mean, it's a mechanical automatic systems and electronic system like that. And finally is 211.7.2, talking about the filters of the equipments. So let me explain one by one in detail. So 211.6.3, equipment design, size and location. So equipment used in the manufacture, processing, packing or holding of a drug product shall be of a appropriate design, adequate size and suitability located to facilitate operations for its intended use and for its cleaning and maintenance. So equipment construction. Equipment shall be constructed so that surfaces that contact components, in process materials or drug products shall not be reactive, additive or absorptive, so as to alter the safety, identity, strength, quality or purity of the drug product beyond official or other established requirements. So this is very important, equipment construction. So the equipment construction may not impact on our product. Any substances required for operation such as lubricants or coolant shall not come into contact with the components, drug product containers, closures, in process materials or drug product so as to alter the safety, identity, strength, quality, purity of the drug product beyond the official or other established requirements. This is very important because most of the equipments use lubricants for fermenters and vessels. So there will be a chance of mix-ups, so we have to take care of there is no mix-up contact with the product. And 211.6.7, equipment cleaning and maintenance. This is very important when switched to the equipment cleaning. So equipment and utensils shall be cleaned, maintained and sanitized at appropriate intervals to prevent malfunctions or contamination that would alter the safety, identity, strength, quality or purity of the drug product beyond the official or other established requirements. Most we do cleanings before going to start the production. We do do the cleaning like CAP clean in place, and post usage also we do the cleaning in place operations. So written procedures shall be established and followed for cleaning and maintenance of equipment, including utensils used in the manufacture, processing, packing or holding of a drug product. These procedures shall include but are not necessarily limited to the following. So actually FDA says about whatever we do in the pharmaceuticals, whether it's a beginning of the process like dispensing to dispatch, each and every process we do is we should have the written procedures like standard operating procedures. So a few sub points is there. So the first one is assignment of responsibility for cleaning and maintaining equipment. Maintenance and cleaning schedules, including where appropriate sanitizing schedules. And third one is a description in sufficient detail of the methods, equipment and materials used in cleaning and maintenance operations, and the methods of disassembling and reassembling equipments as necessary to assure proper cleaning and maintenance. And fourth one is removal or obliteration of previous batch identification, protection of clean equipment from contamination prior to use. These are the checklists we are when we are going to do cleaning or when we are going to do the line cleans for the batch. So these are the few critical points to ensure. And next one is inspection of equipment for clean lines immediately before use. So what I said is just like line clearance. And support C, in that records shall be kept of maintenance, cleaning, sanitizing and inspection as specified in 211.180 and 211.182. So whatever we're doing, cleaning activities and maintenance activities, we have to thoroughly do the concurrent documentation for evidence of operations. So we will do or discuss about 211.180 and 211.182 in upcoming topics. And next one is 211.68, automatic mechanical and electronic equipment. In that, automatic mechanical or electronic equipment are other types of equipment including computers or related systems that will perform a function satisfactorily. It may be used in the manufacture, processing, packing and holding of a drug product. If such equipment is so used, it shall be routinely calibrated, inspected or checked according to the written program designed to assure proper performance. Written records of those calibration checks and inspection shall be maintained. Appropriate control shall be exercised over computer or related systems to assure that changes in master production and control records or other records are instituted only by authorized personnel. Input to and output from the computer or related system of formulas or other records or data shall be checked for accuracy. The degree and frequency of input or output verification shall be based on complexity and reliability of the computer or related system. A backup file of data entered into the computer or related system shall be maintained except where certain data such as calculation performed in connection with the laboratory analysis are eliminated by the computerization or other automated process like that. In such instances, a written record of the program shall be maintained along with appropriate validation data. Hard copy or alternative systems such as duplications, tapes or microfilm designed to assure that backup data are exact and complete, and that is it is secure from alteration and inadvertent and erasures or loss shall be maintained. Next topic is 211.72, filters. Filters for liquid filtration used in the manufacturer, processing or packing of injectable drug products intended for human use shall not release fibers into such products. This is a very important point. And fiber releasing filters may not be used in the manufacture, processing, packing of these injectable drug products unless it is not possible to manufacture such drug products without the use of such filters. If use of fiber releasing filter is necessary, an additional non-fiber releasing filter of 0.22 micron maximum mean porosity 0.45 micron if the manufacturing condition dictate shall subsequently be used to reduce the content of particles in the injectable drug product. Use of an asbestos containing filter with or without subsequent use of a specific non-fiber releasing filter is permissible only upon submission of proof to the appropriate Bureau of the Food and Drug Administration that use of non-fiber releasing filter will or is likely to compromise the safety or effectiveness of the injectable drug product. Questions and answers. Please express your concerns on this tutorial and post under the comments box. We do feel happy if you like this session, and please comment and subscribe to PBS India. Thank you.